Hello friends, welcome to ActionScript video tutorial series. In the previous video tutorial, we started discussing increment and decrement operators in ActionScript. We understood that increment and decrement operators are used to increment or decrement a variable value by 1. Pair of plus symbols indicate increment operator. Pair of minus symbols indicate decrement operator. Increment operator is used to increment a variable value by 1, whereas decrement operator is used to decrement a variable value by 1. There are two kinds of increment, post-increment and pre-increment. There are two kinds of decrement, post-decrement and pre-decrement. If we place the increment operator after the variable name, it is considered as post-increment. If we place the increment operator before the variable name, it is considered as pre-increment. If we place the decrement operator after the variable name, it is considered as post-decrement. If we place the decrement operator before the variable name, it is considered as pre-decrement. In the previous video tutorial, we understood that if we do post-increment or pre-increment, both the places, the variable value will be incremented by 1. Whether we do post-decrement or pre-decrement, both the places the variable value will be decremented by 1. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss what is the difference between post-increment and pre-increment. What is the difference between post-decrement and pre-decrement? So, let's have a demonstration. I go to Adobe Flash. You can see that I have already launched the Flash IDE. I click on ActionScript 3.0 to create a new ActionScript file. I go to Timeline. Click on the first frame, go to Window menu, click on Actions to get the Actions window. I got the Actions window here. In the previous video tutorial, we created a variable called as A, of type integer. Within that, we placed the value 10. And then, using the trace function, we displayed the value of A by saying A equal to A, bracket close, semicolon. What output we get here if I run the code? A equal to 10. If I hit Control Enter, in the output window, you see A equal to 10 got displayed. Then, to increment the variable value by 1, we say A plus plus semicolon. We can display the value of A once the increment happens by using the trace function. What output I get here? We get A equal to 11 displayed. If I hit Control Enter, in the output window, you see A equal to 11 got displayed. Let me explain how this code gets executed behind the scene. We know that the ActionScript code are going to be executed instruction by instruction, one after the another, top to down, right? First, where A equal to 10 will get executed. Of course, A is going to have the value 10. Once we say trace A equal to A, A equal to 10 will be displayed in the output window. And then it moves to the next statement. The system moves to the next statement. We have there A plus plus semicolon. This is only one instruction. Actually, A plus plus semicolon is going to be expanded to two statements behind the scene. There are two statements are there here. What are they? The first statement will be A equal to A, assignment statement, and then increment statement, A equal to A plus 1 semicolon. In one statement, A plus plus semicolon, we have two statements, A equal to A semicolon and A equal to A plus 1 semicolon. What happens here is A equal to A semicolon, the first statement, is going to be executed in the same place where we have written A plus plus semicolon. That means A equal to A semicolon statement will be executed in the same place where we have written A plus plus semicolon. And A equal to A plus 1 semicolon statement is going to be executed before executing the next statement. Somewhere around here, that statement will be placed, friends. Now what happens? Of course, the previously the value of A is 10. 10 will be placed back in the A. On this line, the value of A will be 10, friends. And then A equal to A plus 1 semicolon will get executed. Previous value of A is 10, so 10 plus 1 is 11, 11 will be assigned to A. So the current value of A is what? 11. When we say trace A equal to A, we get the output A equal to 11 displayed on the screen. If I hit Control Enter, you see the same output, A equal to 10, A equal to 11, there is no change. instead of writing a equal to a semicolon, a equal to a plus 1 semicolon, two statements, we can simply say a plus plus semicolon, right? Remember that this single instruction has two instructions. The first instruction is a equal to a semicolon assignment. The second instruction will be a equal to a plus 1 semicolon, that is increment. The first instruction will be executed in the same place where we have written a plus plus semicolon, and the second instruction a equal to a plus 1 semicolon will be executed before executing the next statement somewhere around here, right? If I hit control enter, there is no change, we got the output properly. That is the post increment, friends. Now we understand pre-increment. I comment this code forward slash star and star forward slash. If I hit control enter, we don't have any code for execution, right? No output. Again, I create a variable a, put the value 10 inside it, and then we can display the value of a on the screen by using trace function. If I hit control enter, you see a equal to 10 got displayed there. To increment the variable value by 1, this time I use pre-increment plus plus a semicolon, and then I display the value of a using the trace function. We know that we get the output here a equal to 11. If I hit control enter, you see a equal to 10, a equal to 11 got displayed. Now how this statement will get executed? Here again same thing as I told, it is going to have two different statements behind the scene. First statement will be increment a equal to a plus 1 semicolon, and the second statement will be assignment a equal to a semicolon. In single statement we have two statements, friends. The first statement a equal to a plus 1 semicolon will be executed in the same place where we have done plus plus a semicolon, and the second statement a equal to a is going to be executed before executing the next statement somewhere around here. This is how the code works behind the scene. First, a value will be 10, a equal to a means a equal to 10 will get displayed here. Then the system moves to the next statement, a equal to a plus 1 semicolon. Here what happens, the previous value of a is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11, 11 will be assigned to a. So in that place the value of a is 11, and then a equal to a statement will get executed. Previously the value of a is 11, now 11 will be assigned to a, so current value of a is going to become 11. Then this statement will get executed, a equal to 11 will be displayed on the screen. If I hit control enter, you see the output displayed a equal to 10, a equal to 11. There is no change, right? Instead of writing like this, simply we can write plus plus a semicolon. Remember that this instruction has two statements. The first statement will be a equal to a plus 1 semicolon, the second statement will be a equal to a semicolon. First increment, then assignment, pre-increment, right? A equal to a plus 1 semicolon will be executed in the same place where we have done plus plus a semicolon. A equal to a will be executed before executing the next statement. If I hit control enter, we see the same output, a equal to 10, a equal to 11. Hope you guys have understood what is the difference between post increment and pre-increment. In the post-increment, the increment happens after the assignment. In the pre-increment, the increment happens before the assignment. Now we proceed to the post-decrement and pre-decrement. If I hit control enter, we don't see any output because everything is a comment. Now again, I create a variable a, where a equal to 10. I display the value of a here. And then to decrement the value of a by 1, I use a minus minus semicolon. This time we are doing decrement. And then I display the value of a using the trace function. We know that here we are getting the output 9. If I hit control enter, we see a equal to 10, a equal to 9 got displayed. Let me explain how this code is going to be executed behind the scene. Of course, first 10 will be placed in a. Then a equal to a equal to 10 will get displayed there. A minus minus is going to be expanded to two statements. A equal to a assignment, a equal to a minus 1 decrement. There are two statements are there in one single statement. First assignment, then decrement. The first assignment statement is going to be executed in the same place where we have done a minus minus, and a equal to a minus 1 statement will be executed just before executing the next statement, maybe somewhere around here. Understanding? So the previous value, that is the current value of a, is what? 10 here. 10 will be assigned back to a. So in this place the value of a will be 10. Then a equal to a minus 1 will be executed. What is the current value of a, or the previous value of a, is 10. 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 will be assigned to a. So that is going to be the new value, or the current value of a is what? 9. Then this statement will get executed. A equal to 9 will be displayed on the screen. If I hit Control Enter, you see the same output. A equal to 10, A equal to 9 displayed there. Instead of writing like this, we can simply say A minus minus semicolon. Remember that this statement has two statements. A equal to A semicolon, A equal to A minus 1 semicolon. A equal to A will get executed in the same place. A equal to A minus 1 will be executed just before executing the next statement. Remember that. Now I'm going to hit Control Enter to see the output. A equal to 10, A equal to 9. I'm going to comment this code. Forward slash star and then star forward slash. Everything is comment. If I hit Control Enter, we don't see any output. No output is there. Let's proceed and write the decrement statement. Here I create a variable A of type integer, other than the value 10 to that, and then I copy this code and paste down. If I hit Control Enter, you see the output A equal to 10 displayed there. And then what I do, I am going to decrement the variable value by 1 by using minus minus a semicolon this time. And then we can display the value of a by using the trace function. We get a equal to 9. If I hit Control Enter, you see a equal to 9 got displayed. How this code executes? First, 10 will be assigned to a. The current value of a is 10. A equal to a means a equal to 10 will be displayed in the output window. Then the system moves to this statement. Minus minus a has two statements behind the scene. First, a equal to a minus 1 decrement, and then assignment a equal to a semicolon. The decrement statement a equal to a minus 1 is going to be executed in the same place where we have done minus minus a semicolon, and assignment statement a equal to a is going to be executed just before executing the next statement somewhere here. When the system executes this line, the current value of a is 10 here. So 10 minus 1 is 9. So in this place the value of a is 9. And then assignment will get executed. 9 will be placed back in a. So current value of a is 9. A equal to a will display a equal to 9 on the screen. If I hit Control Enter, you see the output a equal to 9 displayed there. Instead of writing like this, we can simply write minus minus a semicolon. Remember that this statement has two statements. First statement will be a equal to a minus 1 decrement. The second statement will be a equal to a assignment. First decrement, then assignment. Decrement statement is going to be executed in the same place. Assignment statement will be executed just before executing the next statement. If I hit Control Enter, we see the same output, a equal to 10, a equal to 9. That is the difference between post decrement and pre decrement, friends. Post decrement, first assignment, then decrement. Pre decrement, first decrement, then assignment. If you see with respect to the output, there is no difference. With respect to the output, there is no difference. But with respect to the execution, there is a difference between post increment and pre increment, post decrement and pre decrement. When you use the increment and decrement operators independently like this as a single instruction, or independent instruction, you don't find any difference in the output. There will be a difference in the output when we use increment and decrement operators in an expression or in a function call. There will be a difference in the output also. We see that in the next video tutorial. In this video tutorial, I hope you guys have understood how the post increment and pre increment, post decrement and pre decrement instructions are executed. What is the difference between them? For this video tutorial, this much is enough, friends. In the next video tutorial, we get more information on increment and decrement operators. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel And don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial.